Hi everyone! As I got new viewers on my channel, I started to receive questions about my first works, from which this wonderful hobby is started, and also about my top 10 favorite art supplies and top 10 favorite coloring books. If you follow my channel for a long time, and I am really very grateful to everyone who supported my channel since the beginning, you probably won't be hearing anything new, but I enjoyed talking about my art supplies and about my coloring books, so I hope that you still will find something interesting. I am not afraid to show my first pictures. My first coloring book was a book about Paris, which I purchased as a souvenir from France, and I started to color in it with Derwentine tints. This picture with a pond is my first ever finished coloring project since my childhood. You can see that everything looked quite simple here. For both pages I used ink tints. Here I also tried to do some shadows, but not very successfully. And you know, it was fun to compare this picture with a picture from Manuel de Bonheur, which I made last year, I believe. When I colored it, I had very sweet memories about one of my first projects from Paris book, and it was nice to compare my skills then and now. When I started to color, I wasn't very experienced in where to put shadows, how to color different subjects like fur. You can see how my cat looks. I gradually started to learn how to use ink tints, how to mix colors, how to attract attention to the focal point of the picture. Here I also started to use Derwent tinted graphite pencils, so pictures looked a little bit dirty, and I realized that I need more art supplies. So next I purchased this book by Johanna Basford. This is my second coloring book, and I also purchased Derwent Color Soft pencils. I was incredibly proud of myself when I started to do these leaves, when I started to learn how to do shading and color gradients. You can see that I didn't do any backgrounds for my first projects, and it's also okay when you just start to learn. You have to go slowly, step by step. I think that it's nice when you start from learning how to combine colors by learning your art supplies better, and then you can gradually make more and more complicated projects. My third coloring book was Magical City, and my first finished picture was this Egypt, again with Derwent ink tints. And again, I was incredibly proud of my result. But then, I was very lucky to find a video from Peter Hewitt and to compare her picture for Egypt and mine result. And it was the moment when I realized that if I want to get similar result, I have to be more patient and to spend much more time and to be much more invested in my projects, to do proper shading, to use more colors, and I have to learn. So thanks to Peter, started my wonderful journey into coloring. Next question is about my top 10 art supplies. And you know that my two favorite art supplies is Prismacolor and Polychromos pencils. I can't say that I prefer one to another. I have some points in favor of each brand. So the first point for Prismacolors is that I really love their white pencil. Especially I love it combining with dark colors like black grape, like indigo, like black cherry. It creates amazing shading. Second point to Prismacolors, it's because I love pastel colors. Pale sage, cream, eggshell, deco pink, deco peach, cloud blue are my favorite colors. And if I need to color something pastel, I definitely prefer to use Prismacolors. Also, I love black Prisma, and that's why it's already ended. It's really nice and opaque black. Third reason why I prefer Prismacolors is because I love their gray selection, especially French grays, which are a mix of gray with a little bit of brown. I could never realize that I could be in love with gray pencils, but now I started to use them more and more, and I really love warm gray, cool gray, and especially unique French grays. And I also think that Prismacolors are more suitable for my way of coloring. I prefer to color quickly and not to do many layers. Now let's talk why I prefer polychromos. First reason is, for me, polychromos are much easier to use if I want to color skin. For portraits, I definitely would prefer to use polychromos. And the second, it's because of their green selection. I think that green in polychromos set are much more natural looking, and selection of colors is amazing. I also love black polychromos, but not as a black, because it's transparent black, not very dark. But I love to use it together with other pencils to make colors darker. My next favorite art supply is my Derwent Burnisher, which I use from the beginning of my hobby, and it always helped me to get more smooth coverage. And it also helped me to save money for pencils, because I can apply pencils in just one layer, and then I use my burnisher and I smooth and mix colors on the paper. Even on the cheap paper, my burnisher always helped me with all pencils brand. Next is my very simple sharpener. I definitely prefer this simple long point sharpeners from German manufacturer Kamm. I change them quite quickly and I love how they work. My next favorite art supply is titanium white paint, and here I have gouache paint, but I also like titanium white acrylic paint. My white paint is quite opaque and I can use it instead of Posca pen or instead of white gel pen. I can create with it effect of shining when I applied it in semi-transparent way with a little bit of water, or I can use it for covering black lines. I think that it's one of my must-have art supplies, and it's also quite cheap. It's much cheaper than purchasing new Posca pens. Next are my favorite watercolor brushes. Both are quill brushes from Jackson's Art. They are a mix of synthetic and squirrel hair, and I love everything about them. I love their thin tip, I love how they hold water and paint, and I also like their price. Now I use them not only for watercolors, but also for applying water to inktense and for neo colors. And next thing in my top 10 list is my new color crayons. I already made, I think, 3 videos about my love to these art supplies, and I still learn how to use them in new and new ways, but they saved me so much time in doing backgrounds. They helped me to create backgrounds in a very quick and easy way, even in books where paper isn't thick for watercolors. And I love everything about them, their colors, their behavior on paper, and also that they are quite economical. By the way, in June I made a video about 20 my favorite neocolor colors, so I will leave you a link to that video. And my next favorite medium is this pearl and metallic watercolors. They are my must-have for creating backgrounds, especially in Hannah's book. Probably this set is the most versatile because it has two wonderful metal colors, this copper and gold, and also has wonderful selection of pearl blue, pearl green and pale pink colors, which are really very good to mix them with watercolors, with acrylic paint, with nail colors to add some details. But I love all my sets of metal and pearl watercolors. I have this Gansai Tambi golden watercolors, and I also own couple of sets of fine tag pearls, and they are really very fun to play and very good looking. Next is Derwent drawing pencils, and you know that they are quite unique both in properties, they are very creamy and very opaque, and also in their natural colors. Now I think that I definitely have to color something with them, maybe in August or in September. Nice set for autumn colors. My next favorite medium is my inktense, and you probably know everything about me and inktense, so I won't be wasting your time for another praises about inktense. I just don't want to repeat myself once again and once again. Now let's go to my favorite coloring books, and you know that I love each and every coloring book and in my collection. They are all for me very inspiring, but still, some of them are my total favorites, and I tried to select pictures which are good in quality and inspiring and a little bit challenging for me to color. And of course, the first one is book by Tomislav Tomic. I love its exquisite art style, and I love all books where I can find castles, knights, fairies, dragons, so it's totally for me. It's not easy for me to color, I struggle sometimes, I get tired because I have to use only my colored pencils and not water-based mediums, but still, it's my favorite coloring book. But I think that Manuel de Bonheur by Kanoska Yeguza is almost equal. First of all, this book has excellent quality, and I am totally in love with this paper. In this book, I can work with watercolors, with neocolors, and with all pencils brand. Paper is amazing for shading, mixing, and even with one layer, everything looks amazing. And of course, I love these cute animals, but I also love all botanical details. I love how detailed are all designs. And I don't know why, but somehow this book is very easy for me to color. When I just watched reviews for this book, I was so afraid to color animals, I didn't know how to color fur or feathers, and now I enjoyed all pictures. And I think that all projects which I finished in this book are definitely in my favorite in my list of finished projects. Next are two books by Hannah Carson, and I selected Magical Dawn and Soulmates. I don't know how to explain that Magical Dawn is the most inspiring Hannah's book for me. Here I have majority of finished pictures. Here on almost each pages I used mixed media, so almost all pictures are like experiments for me. Here I am not afraid to color portraits, and again, I don't know why. In this book I have my most successful experiments with background. And I hope that maybe one day I will be able to finish it. I included Soulmates in my current top 10 coloring books list, even if I hadn't started it yet. Shame on me. But I really love that Hannah is going higher and higher with each coloring book. Then I really love variety of subjects. You can find here her traditional flowers, traditional animals, but also something new. And also I love that here we have so many portraits that you can color them without any fear. If I am not very successful with one portrait, I can go to the next one. And of course, I am totally in love with the quality of this Dutch edition. Next is Leila Dule. You probably know everything about my love to this artist and about my love to the Flower Yearbook. I also purchased Floribunda, but I hadn't started it yet. I love both books because of the artist style, about how detailed are designs here, about composition of each picture, and I also love paper quality. When I discovered how well paper in Flower Year behaves with water-based mediums, my love just became 10 times bigger. And paper in Floribunda is even better. It's like a thick cardstock. Next in my list, I have a book by Jasmine Beckett Griffiths. I already mentioned in the video about works finished in July that after a couple of finished projects, I am totally in love with the book. I love that here we have very cute images and selection and nice variety of subjects again. I think that Jasmine is very talented in drawing animals and flowers. I love that she included a lot of gothic, dark, themed images connected to Edgar Allan Poe, to Halloween, so not only sweet images. And you probably know that in August will be published new book by Jasmine Beckett Griffith, totally dedicated to Alice, and I am dying from desire to get this book. I also like that she included some small projects, which I am able to finish quite quickly. And of course, all books by Blue Angel Publishers are of highest quality. Paper is amazing. Next is book by Meredith Dillman. I have this issue of Coloring Haven. I can't say anything about quality of her two coloring books, but I hope that they are quite decent, because the style of Meredith Dillman is really worth to purchase books and to color. I love that we have here projects of different difficulty, and some are more detailed and some are simpler and easier to finish. I love this mix of medieval style, fairy tales, beautiful botanical details, and also that she included a lot of Asian style pictures. And I also like that faces are not very big, so it's easy to color even for beginners. Also, I like composition of her designs. And the next book I also included in this list because of the beauty of faces and because of compositions. And it's Fairy Tales by Selina Fennick. I decided to include it in my top 10 list of my current favorite coloring books because I'm totally in love with composition. Even if paper is a little bit thin for my taste, I am sure that I will be enjoying each and every moment of coloring in this book. And in the end, I wanted to add something unexpected to my top 10 list, so I decided to include here books in which I hadn't started to color yet or finished only one project. So next we have Pictura books. I think that Pictura books have amazing selection of artists which they invited to participate. For example, here I have A Medieval Town by Levi Pinfold, and I just enjoy to look at these pictures. I don't even have to color in it. I use it as an art book by an artist. Also, I have here coloring book by John Ho. I was a huge fan of John Ho since I discovered his works for Hobbit and for the Lord of the Rings. And I was attentively following his works and I watched all videos about his works for movies for Lord of the Rings. So that's why I purchased this big coloring book about dragons, and I also like that it looks like an artist art book printed in pale gray color. And the last one is my Briar coloring book. It's a shame and pity that I hadn't colored in it for a long time. I finished here only one picture. I love everything here, subjects and artist style, and it's totally my fault that I continue to color in books which are more popular in coloring community. I think about what will be more popular on video, and that's why I forgot to color in my less popular but probably even more beautiful books. I think that I definitely have to correct this mistake. It's great that thanks to this question about my current top 10 favorite coloring books, I was able to remember about my slightly neglected but still favorite books. I thank you for watching and for listening, and I hope that it wasn't very boring. I tried to be not very long.